This is the gargoyle of the Front Row Fanatics, and you're watching my two good friends on Top Rope Reality. What you want? This is the Pro Wrestling Review, the Monday Night Wars, February 3rd to the 24th of February, 1997.
Back in the day.
Yes, we're going to do
February. That's 20 years ago.
It's 20 years ago.
That's scary.
Let's see what happened 20 years ago.
We are old.
Yeah, speak for yourself.
Oh, we're speaking for you for sure, buddy.
I'm young at heart. Oh, my heart!
Right. God.
Let's start off with Raw on February 3rd. It was a dark match as Rocky Maivia defeated the Sultan.
I did it for the Rock.
I love
the Sultan. Because that's Rikishi. Just in case nobody knew that. Vader with Paul Bearer, we were just talking about him. Part 1. So watch it if you didn't watch it. Defeated Steve Austin by disqualification in 8 minutes and 13 seconds.
Hey, we got times. All right.
Hey, yeah.
That'll last probably one segment.
Probably.
We got Savio Vega defeating Flash Funk.
Flash, you are so funky.
And 421.
Oh, not 420. Oh, no. Oh, almost got you. Almost got you. Then we got Doug Furnas and Phil Lafon defeating Owen Hart and Davey Boy Smith in a WWF Tag Team Championship match by countout. 14 minutes and 30 seconds. We must be into three-hour shows now. Or 2 hours.
I don't know, because looking at March, it's kind of scary. Crush defeated Goldust in 8:19.
I don't know, those are long matches, though.
They are long matches.
I feel like it has to be 2 hours.
Ooh, that's bad, then.
Hunter Hearst Helmsley, who's your WWF Intercontinental Champion, defeated Marc Mero to retain the championship in 13:57.
We have The Undertaker and Ahmed Johnson defeating Faarooq and Mankind in a No Holds Barred Tag Team
Easy for you
match
to say.
In 2029. Yes, it is. 10:29. Let me do that again.
My tongue No got... Holds Barred Tag Team match.
My tongue gets away. My big tongue.
And then we have a dark match to end the night. Shawn Michaels, who is your WWF Champion, defeated Bret Hart and Sycho Sid in a triple threat match.
This is a dark match and no time. That's a pretty good show.
I mean, that actually is a good show. Better than what they've been doing up to this point.
Well, you remember this for next week when we do March.
Uh-oh. Maybe they reverted back to an hour. Testing the waters.
They did something. Now we're going to jump over here to Nitro. Monday Night Nitro for people out there. Nitro was.
They're like, "Whoa, Nitro! You talking about Johnny? Yeah. Oh, Johnny Nitro?"
We got the Ultimate Dragon with Sonny Onoo defeating Mendez Jr.
Melendez, yeah, something like that.
Yeah. And three.
Mendoza.
Mendoza.
Sorry. Ray Mendoza.
Jr.
Not Ray Mysterio Jr.
Booyakabo, oh, sorry.
Right.
And 3:13.
And then we have Glacier. I know that guy. Defeated Billy Kidman in 2:08. They love their short matches on this show.
I'm glad you're not a name dropper.
Not at all. Adam Rose.
Who?
Exactly. Who's not apparently retiring. He lied to you!
His pants are on fire then, ain't it?
They should be. Because he's got some bookings in January and February already.
Ooh, liar, liar.
Yeah, liar, liar.
Now, let's talk about Ice Train, who could be or could not be a liar, I'm not sure.
With Ice Teddy Train Long, should have teamed up with the Ho Train.
That's true. He defeated La Parka in 5:15.
Who hasn't? Harlem Heat booked his Stevie Ray with Sister Sherri versus the Steiner brothers, Rick and Scott Steiner, ended in a double disqualification in 5:02.
We got Dean Malenko defeating Mike Knock Enos.
Mike Knock Enos.
Mike Enos.
You were going to say Mike Knox.
Knox, yes.
I hear
it's 7:09.
It's Mike Enos, one half of Rough and Ready.
And also, we used to be part of the Destruction Crew.
And also, the Beverly
Brothers. Yes.
I was thinking Beverly something, wasn't it? What else we got? We got Diamond Dallas Page defeating the Renegade.
Who is not the Ultimate Warrior.
In 2:03.
We got Alex
Wright. But they both passed away.
Yes.
The Ultimate Warrior and the fake Ultimate Warrior.
We got Alex Wright.
Das Wunderkid.
Thank you.
Was I supposed to be saying
yes,
that?
Yes, yes.
You know, all three Ultimate Warriors are dead. Isn't that scary?
It is scary.
The Ultimate Warrior, the fake one, Renegade, and the one they thought was the Ultimate Warrior, Texas Tornado.
That is true. That's very scary.
Weird.
And only your mind thinks of that.
Only mine.
Hey, Alex Wright.
Das Wunderkid.
Defeated Super Calo.
Fragilistic Israelidocious.
Oh, wait.
I think I got that right.
I don't know. You run over all over it. So.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Yeah, the middle was missing.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Hey, there it is.
Something like that.
Oh, sounds pretty good.
And then we have Conan the Barbarian with Jimmy Hart defeating Chris with Woman via disqualification in 4:15. You know, if she was stayed married to Kevin Sullivan, she might still be here.
That's true.
I know that's sad to say, I'm sorry, but
That's true, though. What if?
What if?
So and sad. Then the main event.
Oh, that's sad. Okay, so Raw won this week.
We got Jeff Jarrett.
Who could never main event anything in his life.
Defeated Steve Mongo McMichaels with Deborah McMichaels by countout.
What? He was part of.
Disqualification of countout.
And look how short the match was.
2:19.
One half, or not one half, but he was part of Da Bears.
Right?
Yeah, Steve Mongo. Part of Da Bears. You know what I'm talking about, though.
Yeah, Chicago Bears. Which is okay.
But you know what I'm talking about, though, right? Saturday Night Live. Da Bears.
That's true, yeah.
Da Bears, Da Bears, Da Bears, Da Bears.
What makes me sad is he was part of
the Four Horsemen,
yes.
Da Horsemen.
Sorry, Steve Mongo McMichael's name should never, ever be. In any sentence with the Four Horsemen.
I know it's sad, but I think I'd rather have Mongo than have Paul Roma in there, though. Just put that out there.
I forgot he was in part of it, yeah.
Sid Vicious is part of it, too. Why?
I'm okay with Sid. He's muscled with these two goofs.
But he's also an idiot, because he's got half the brain that you do. Yeah, really. Then we start off again with a Nitro. February the... Why does it say 10-13?
Because Raw was on the Thursday, the 13th.
The dog show. Must have been all stupid people doing
that. Yeah, the dog show.
So February the 10th, we have Nitro. Raw will be February the 13th. And we have Dean Malenko starting the show out, taking on Eddie Guerrero. This was Dean Malenko, the Cruiserweight Champion, defeating Eddie Guerrero, the U.S. Champion. That, okay, good. Because I'm about to say, if it was a clean win, you don't have your Cruiserweight Champion beat your U.S. Champion.
No, you don't.
But it was by countout in a champion versus champion match in 4:50s.
And you know the title cannot change hands on a count out.
Smart.
Then we jump over to a big match to last 1:22 as Conan the Barbarian defeated the tag team specialist Bobby Eaton.
Beautiful. Bobby Eaton.
Yeah.
Yes. Then.
Or Earl. Robert Eaton.
Yes.
Or Bodacious, but no, sorry.
That's not Bodacious. Yeah, it was weird. What was it? Earl Robert Eaton?
Mm-hmm.
was very weird. Anyway, then we have the Giant defeating Jim Powers' brother, Ron Powers, in 1 minute, 47 seconds. The fact that Ron Powers lasted longer with the Giant than Bobby Eaton did with Conan is a problem.
That's a huge problem. Scratch that one off there in 47 seconds.
That should have been it.
That would have been 47
better. 47 seconds.
But a minute 47, he must did a lot of running.
Jab and run. Jab and run.
Should be one jab and you get grabbed.
Thank you.
And it's...
Exactly.
We have the Steiner brothers. Reagan's going to have Steiner. The dog pound. Defeated High Voltage, Kenny Chaos, and Robbie Rage.
High Voltage, get it?
I get it.
Okay.
In 4:30.
10 less seconds, and High Voltage would have been getting real high. The Outsiders, Kevin Nash and Scott Hall, who are your tag team champions, with 6, defeated the Extreme. That's it, just the Extreme. Ace Darling and Devin Storr. Must have been from ECW. Because I think Devin Storm is a crowbar. I think. But it lasted 1 minute, 27 seconds. The Extreme lasted longer than Bobby Eaton did. What's wrong with this
But
kid?
Less than Ron Powers. Who took on the giant, for God's sake.
Ron Powers, he must have been real good.
Was that really the Yeti? I can understand maybe then, but come on.
That might have been that guy. Which was Ron Reese, which is another name he went by.
Right.
Yeah.
I may have to
Our big
see.
Ron stud
I
was another
I guy. May have to look to see who this competition is for the Giant to last longer than a tag team match and Conan and Bobby Eaton, for goodness sakes. Jeez Louise.
Jeez Louise.
Now we got another title match. It is for the WCW World Television Championship. NXT needs a TV title.
NXT needs the network championship. That's what they need.
Need something. And the Lord Steven Regal, the champion, taking on Rey Mysterio Jr.
Booyaka.
But in a time limit draw of that big 6 minutes and 56 seconds.
What I'm hoping is that is TV time because there was a commercial breaks in there and it equaled 15. But when this person timed this out, when they put it on the site they put it on, because we all know where they put it at. Hopefully.
You're hoping, aren't you, cuz?
I'm hoping they just timed the actual match they saw while it was on TV.
Because when was the last time we saw a time limit match in like 10, 15?
Never?
Time limit of 8 minutes, 32. What the hell is it?
So hopefully they had a commercial break in there and it made 15 altogether.
Good logic.
I'm trying to help you
Probably
out.
Probably not right, but good logic.
I'm about to get mad about this one, too. Kevin Sullivan with Jacqueline and Jimmy Hart defeated Maverick Wild.
Woo!
In 2 minutes and 13 seconds, who lasted longer than Bobby Eaton.
And Conan.
Going against Conan! What are these jobber? Who are they talking to get this extra time on television?
I know.
Maverick Wild.
That's a god-awful name.
You could have been called Wild Maverick, and I would have been okay with it, but you're Maverick Wild. Couldn't even put the words in the right order.
No. And now we have Hugh Morris.
Yes.
Defeated Alex Wright.
Das Wonder Kid.
In 2:27.
Who lasted long? I'm just kidding.
Alex Wright's okay. We'll give him a pass.
Wow, these people are destroying the main event scene. What's wrong with these people? Chris Benoit, Steve Mongo McMichaels from Duffers with Deborah and Woman defeated, oh, you guessed it, Jeff Jarrett. And oddly enough, out of nowhere, why is this guy in the main event? Jeff Jarrett must have been like, look, I just need a partner. He might have been looking all night for a partner, you know?
Yes.
Chavo Guerrero Jr. in 4 minutes, 1 second. They lasted longer. I'm just kidding. Okay, but honestly, why are Jarrett and McMichael in the main event matches? I would have rather seen the Outsiders beat the Extreme in the main event. Or how about Lord Steven Regal versus Rey Mysterio in the main event? Or, better yet, let's put Ron Powers in the main event.
Yeah, I don't know why.
Why are the, I mean, I guess it's horseman problems here. But nobody wants to see Steve Mongo McMichael and Jeff Jarrett in the main event 2 weeks in a row.
That's true.
What is wrong with you people?
This can't be when they won 83 weeks.
We're getting there.
We're getting there, though. Yeah, trust me. March. All I'm saying is March.
It must be real bad.
Rocky Maivia defeated WWF Intercontinental Champion Hunter Hearst Helmsley to win the title.
What? No time.
And they did this on Thursday, so you know they had to do something big.
They filmed it on Monday.
Yeah.
They put it on a Thursday. Or they could have filmed it when they did the whole 2 weeks at a time.
Yeah.
Could have filmed it with the week before show. The Headbangers defeated Aldo Montoya, who has a jockstrap on his head.
He does.
And Bob Holly, the old bodacious one. The old spark plug. The old hardcore guy.
Yeah.
Any other things we could go with?
That's about it.
You know, he weighed over 400 pounds, according to that storyline, for a while. Remember him and Crash Holly would come in, and they brought a scale with them at all times?
I thought it was just...
It may have been Crash mainly, but they did it with both of them, talking about how much they weighed. It was weird.
It was weird.
Weird.
Because I know Crash carried the thing.
He did carry the whole scale with him.
He's so strong.
We have The Undertaker defeating Savio Vega with The Nation.
Who hasn't beaten
him? He better beat Savio Vega.
He better put Ron Powers in there, though, and he'll have some competition.
He went toe-to-toe with a giant.
Steve Austin defeated Psycho Sid via disqualification when Bret Hart attacked Austin. Whoa, we must be leading to the submission match at WrestleMania.
I do smell a submission match.
Oh, do you smell a submission match?
We have Faarooq and Crush defeat the WWF Tag Team Champions Owen Hart and Davey Boy Smith via countout.
Oh, and then this is kind of funny. Yeah, I don't think you read that, did you?
I didn't cut that off only.
So that was your idea.
Yeah, I'm not okay. Cut that off.
Bret Hart defeated Vader.
Yes.
After Vader, we had a miscue on our cue card here.
I don't think you want to read a paragraph worth of what after Vader did. Missed the Vader bomb, probably.
Probably, but we have a miss on our cue card here.
Now we're up to Raw and Nitro, February 17th. We're all back on the same date again.
Yay!
Roughly. And we start off with Marc Mero with Sable defeating Savio Vega with The Nation via disqualification. Not a good start.
Not a good start here. That's definitely not a good start. Oh, the WWF Intercontinental Champion, Rocky Maivia. Rocky sucks. Mm-hmm. Defeated Leaf Cassidy.
But who hasn't?
Al Snow. Oh, you said who hasn't. Yes. Technically, Al Snow has not beat Leaf Cassidy. Unless you want to be real perverted.
I got choked up on that. The Headbangers.
Mm. Whoa. Where are we going with this?
We're talking about Al Snow beating Lee Cassidy.
This is great.
The Headbangers defeated Matt and Jeff Hardy. What?
This is when they were still jobbers.
Okay, well, they looked like Young Bucks.
They looked like Young Bucks, and they had flannel. Plaid, whatever it's called. Flannel, why is that? Plaid. What the heck? WWF Tag Team Champion Owen Hart defeated Flash! Fuck! You are so funky! With the Funkettes. Also known as Brodus Clay with the... Were they called the Funkettes too? What was Naomi and Cameron's name?
Pterodactyls? I don't know.
Pterodactyls. Now I gotta look it up because it would be funny if they were both the Funkettes. Anyway,
Funkadactyls.
Funkadactyls! Pterodactyls, Funkadactyls, you had it right.
I was in the right ballpark. Wrong side of the field, but in the right ballpark. We have Bart Gunn defeated Hunter Hearst Helmsley via countout when Goldust chased Helmsley into the crowd.
Run, Dave!
So he let Rock take his title, and then he went to have a feud with Goldust.
Of course.
Because he was being punished for the... hugging that happened when they had a title, so, yeah.
Exactly. Psycho Sid, who has half the brain that you do, defeated WWF World Heavyweight Champion Bret Hart with the powerbomb to win the title! After Steve Austin interfered and hit the champion with a chair. Well, we couldn't have a title match with a submission match, so they had to get the belt off of him.
Yep, that's right. He was.
Because I think it was what Sycho and Undertaker.
I think it was Sycho and Undertaker.
Ooh, am I smart? Am I smart?
You're back. Remember, WrestleMania.
Because I think it was Sycho.
WrestleMania.
I don't remember what WrestleMania was.
I'm smart.
Yeah, I don't remember what WrestleMania was. I just remember Ken Shamrock was a referee, and they had the submission match, and I think the main event was Sycho and Undertaker. Because the only other option would have been Sycho and Shawn Michaels. But I think Undertaker... I know Undertaker beat Sycho 1 year at WrestleMania. I feel like it has to be that one.
What year? I forget it. Let's move on to Nitro.
Well, what year is this?
1997.
Thank you.
Now, what WrestleMania is that? It's 20 years ago.
I don't know. What number are we at?
34 coming up.
Minus 20. 14.
13. Because, yeah, it'll be this year. So you back it up something.
Oh, yeah, because it didn't have the Roman numeral. It just said WrestleMania 13, and there was, like, fire behind it and all this. Because I'm smart.
I don't think so now. I'm questioning your smartness.
Where are we at?
We're on Rey Mysterio.
We're on Rey Mysterio. Booyaka Booyaka's Hey, defeated Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious in 6 minutes flat.
Time limit draw. 6 minutes flat.
At least it would have been a flat time.
It would have been. It made more sense. Steve Mongo McMichaels defeated
Hugh Morris. He got taken out of the main event, but guess who did?
I know. 421.
Almost. Dean Malenko, who is your Cruiserweight Champion, defeated a WWE Performance Center trainer, Robbie Brookside, to retain the Cruiserweight Championship in 254.
We got Public Enemy defeating the amazing French Canadians with Conrad Parker and 446.
Not going to try to butcher the name.
Nope. Leaving the Carl.
The guy with the eye patch. We're going to leave his name alone.
It's eye patch,
dude. Prince Iakea, before he became a Prince-inspired character, defeated Lord Steven Regal to win!
What?
He won the television championship in 3 minutes and 32 seconds. What is wrong with these people? Oh, my gosh.
The next match.
Oh, my God. I was like, Randy.
Randy Pee-wee Anderson.
It is.
I know. Defeated Nick Patrick. Don't know what he was. He didn't. It's just Nick Patrick.
This was before the NWO, right?
I don't know.
There's no NWO in the matches, but the Giants there.
And 43 seconds. Why were the referees fighting? No telling.
Chris Benoit with Roman defeated Roadblock.
Did you know a joke character?
No. He literally looked like a road sign. He had the yellow and black and everything.
I'm sorry.
In 2 minutes and 30 seconds.
Kevin Sullivan with Jacqueline and Jimmy Hart defeated Doc Dean.
That's a good doctor.
Yes, in 3:20.
Eddie Guerrero, your United States champion, defeated Conan.
Who lasted longer than...
by disqualification in 6:04. Lasted longer than Bobby Eaton. No, I'm just kidding.
The Giant defeated Top Gun and Johnny Swinger in a 2-on-1 handicap match in 40 seconds. Okay, now I've got to go back and watch the Nitro.
You got to find out who Ron Powers is now, because the fact that Top Gun and Johnny Swinger lasted less time together than Ron Powers by himself.
Yeah, that's pretty sad.
That's a problem.
It is a problem.
The Giant was slacking.
Yeah, he made up for it.
Top Gun. Whoever that was. I know Johnny Swinger. I don't know who Top Gun is. And then your main event. Who will not... Why would we get out of the main event?
He was main event material.
Three weeks.
Slap Nut?
That wasn't even during the Slap Nut thing. This was when he was still JWF. This was before... He cut all his hair off. He was still doing the whole long blonde hair and I'm shutting my stiff.
I'm Ric Flair, kind of.
Ric Flair, and I'm better than my daddy because my daddy was a good promoter. And blah, blah, blah. Chris Jericho defeated Jeff Jarrett in 2:30. Lordy be. At least Steve Mongo and Michaels won his match.
Now we jump right back to Nitro on February the 24th in the final week of this one. And we go in a dark match with Joe Gomez defeating Hugh Morris. Wow! It must have been his birthday.
Apparently, because Hugh Morris wasn't laughing with that one. A jobber beat him.
Nope.
It's not good. That's Renegade's tag team partner.
That is.
Then another dark match is Pat Tanaka, who was one half of Bad Company and the Orient Express.
That's it.
Yeah.
Your brain's on a roll.
It's on a roll. Got that coffee in my brain. Isn't working tonight. defeated the Ultimate Dragon, who also is known as Ultimo Dragon.
Yes. Then we start with Public
Enemy. Must have been his birthday, too.
Public Enemy defeated Jeff Jarrett and Steve Mongo McMichaels.
Think of their mind! Really?
What? Main event, then not main event?
No.
Main event, what?
For 2 weeks, they fought each other. In either singles or tag match.
Oh, that's true, yeah.
Then one was in the opening and the other one was in the main event, or the second match of the main event. Now they're in the opening match and they're teaming together. Get along or don't get along. I remember they used to have a lot of fights and stuff when they were both in, what's that thing called? In the Four Horsemen together. They were battling back and forth, but still, goodness gracious. Jim Duggan, he defeated that cell phone, by gosh.
He'll leave it like that. You gotta figure out what cell phone.
Which cell phone did he beat? Next. No, he beat Galaxy. The Galaxy S6.
I'm laughing at the Dark Match Returns here, folks. Hugh Morris defeated Joe Gomez.
He had to get his way back. That crowd had to get behind Hugh Morris, my God.
50-50 booking.
This crowd only knows about that match. The TV people didn't know that Joe Gomez had done one.
I know.
But now Hugh Morris feels better. He's laughing now.
Oh, jeez Louise.
It's all about who laughs last.
That's right. Who best to laughs the best.
So stupid. Oh, but that Galaxy phone, he didn't stand a chance.
It didn't end. Oh!
Anyway.
Will not last against a 2x4.
Oh, no. Even if it's shatterproof, it ain't going to work out for it, is it?
Not like the old rotary.
Then we got
rotary phone, people.
Rotary.
6-3, you know, like that.
I never understood how that best worked. Oh, overspun it.
Yep.
Got to start again. Hang it back up. Anyway. What are we talking about?
Overspin it.
Can you not overspin it?
No. It goes to the little place. You got to put your finger in the right hole, though.
I know.
Go ahead.
That's what she said.
Oh, my God!
Oh! Ow! Anyway, too much coffee.
Oh, no. Ice train.
Ice train. Speaking of hoe. I get it. Because you said
that. Ice coffee, so.
Yeah. Oh, actually, yeah. I was supposed to be ordering a cold coffee, and I got the wrong thing today. I was very upset about that.
Did it have cocaine in it? Because it seemed like you had cocaine in your coffee.
No, that's probably the Subway.
Okay.
No,
Subway had cocaine. Okay, we're not saying Subway sells cocaine.
We're not saying that. It was a joke.
No.
No, I got an eggnog latte, and I meant to say eggnog latte frappuccino.
Oh.
And so I had to drink hot coffee. I don't drink hot coffee. So everybody that knows that wants to send me a Starbucks gift card, ask us on, what's it called? YouTube, how to send it to me.
Yes.
I don't want no hot coffee. Or Facebook, yeah. Absolutely. Ice Train defeated La Parka. That's the point I'm getting to here, people.
And the Faces of Fear, the Barbarian and Ming.
You said their names right.
Wouldn't it be Ming, the Barbarian? Always been Ming.
It was always Ming and the Barbarian. Barbarians always last.
Defeated Eddie Guerrero and Chris Jericho.
What a team.
It's kind of missed. So Jericho went from the main event to a tag match.
Of course. Rey Mysterio Jr.
Booyaka, booyaka.
Defeated Juventud Guerrero. The Juice.
Prince Iakea,
formerly known as
the Prince, yes, Iakea, yes, the furniture.
Artist formerly known as the Prince or something like that. Yeah.
He is your current
television
champion. Yes, I was trying to do WCW and I forget it.
Hey, he came back too.
He defeated Pat Tanaka.
Who? Hey, the crowd was behind him. He got that win in the dark match, and then they said, "Let's put him out there again
to lose."
To lose. The Ultimo Dragon, who was
Joe Gomez, was one of the darn match coming loose against the same person.
So it's weird though, but they both won their dart matches and then they both lost on television. Ultimo Dragon, who lost to Pat Tanaka, came back and defeated Dean Malenko via disqualification.
Right, because it's Ultimate.
They probably mistyped it, but it's the same person. When WCW first brought him in, they called him the Ultimate Dragon, and then they took him and put an O on it and went for there. But anyway, continue.
Whoa. Diamond Dallas Page versus Dave Taylor ended in a no contest.
Why? Why? That was about the same level of Bobby Heaton at that time. So yeah. Why did he now lose? And your main event. Why are we having two in a row? I can't stand WCW when they did that. two no contests in a row. It's Harlem Heat. Took on Lex Luger and the Giant. Why is that a no contest? Why can't we have a good main event here?
That is true.
What's wrong with you folks? But anyway, we're going to jump right very quickly to a Raw for February 24th as you go.
The New Black Jacks defeated Henry and Finis Goldman in 5:49.
Very good. Wow. That's when they were working with ECW. Stevie Richards with Supernova, the Blue Meanie, and 7-Eleven. Which I think was Rob Feinstein, by the way.
Okay, I thought I was talking about the...
Not 9-11, not 911.
No, I'm talking about the gas station, 7-Eleven.
That's the joke, but they were making fun. I think they're making fun of 911.
Okay.
But I'm going to have to go back and look, because I think it was Rob Feinstein.
Well, you know what day it is, then.
Exactly. And they defeated Little Guido at 3 minutes and 41 seconds.
Marlena defeated Sonny via disqualification in an arm wrestling match.
Sonny cheated, by gosh. Goldust, who I guess was already out there probably with Marlena, defeated Savio Vega with the Nation of Dominic, with the nod. It literally says N-O-D, with the nod. They could have just said with the Nation. Via disqualification in 8 minutes and 34 seconds.
Taz will be
on the nod.
And Team Taz.
D'Lo Brown was out there. He had the nod.
Defeated Mikey Whipwreck.
It's easy for you to submission. Say.
Yes, and 2:33. Hey, are we taking booking from Nitro?
Of course. The Legion of Doom fought the Headbanger. Why? The Headbangers to a double countout. 7:44. Why?
Okay, I remember that match. You're thinking, why?
Why?
We have Tommy Dreamer with Beulah, defeated Devon Dudley with Bubba Ray in 4:28.
So I figure why you're extending their names like this. I'm just trying to figure out why Beulah was. She's so nice they had to say it three times?
Yes, because twice isn't enough.
The Undertaker defeated the Faarooq.
The
Faarooq!
Do you smell what the Faarooq is cooking? With the nod!
How's that say? The Undertaker defeated Faarooq with the nod! So it looks like if you read it right, the Undertaker just nodded, and Faarooq was like, oh god. And he was out. Via disqualification. None of these matches ended right! You had disqualification of arm wrestling, disqualification with Goldust and Savio Vega, count out, double count out, and then disqualification. What's wrong with it? This ain't WCW.
Maybe they're getting beat, so they got to be certainly emulating WCW. Lord,
the nod.
Well, that's it. You'll be wishing for the nod in March, so. That's it for part two.
It was long-winded, but it's awesome.
Coming back for part three, as we talk about a lot of things, and which leads us to part four.
So, always does. Yes, three does. Leads to four every time.
I don't know how that does it, but it does it every week.
Every week.
I'm Mike Hogan.
I'm just a cat.
We'll see you in a few clicks. See you next time.